Welcome to this XML manipulation series. In this series, we are going to learn how to work with XML files in VBA. And we are going to learn how to load XML from a file, from a string, how to traverse the XML tree structure, how to create XML from a template file, how to find elements using XPath, and so on. So please be with this series if you want to learn about XML in VBA. So in this first video, I'm going to set up the environment, and for that we need an external library called Microsoft XML version 6.0. Let me show you how to add that in your Excel file. So I have a fully blank Excel file, and I need to go into the developer tab and click on this Visual Basic. Now to work with XML, we need an external library, and we can set the references using this tools and then references, and then find this Microsoft XML version 6.0. You can find the location as well in this section. So check mark that and press OK. Now you can press F2 to see the object browser, and you can select that MS XML 2, and then you can see all the classes that is present, like DOM document 60. You can select any one of these methods and properties, and you can see the documentation for that one. Also, I have added references here, so I'll put that in the Excel file or in the description of this video, so you can go through this as well. So like, you know, IXML, DOM document. So if we open this in a browser, then you'll see that all of these documentation for that DOM document. And if you want to see all the methods and properties description, then you can open this link. And then you can see all the properties and method description with some example code. So if you click on this base name, then you'll see with the base name related code. So we are going to cover the basic in this part of the video, and later on we'll deep dive on this XML. So I have a sample code, so let me just put that sample code here. And you can see I have a file path variable, and that is referencing to this particular XML file. Let me show you that XML file, bookscatalog.xml. And if you look at the structure of this, then you see we have a catalog, and that catalog contains an array of book, and each book contains different property, like, you know, author, title, genre, price, published date, and description. And the author is also an object with the first name and last name property. So we are going to load this XML from this file, and then we are going to try to traverse this in this video series, and we are going to work with some other XML file as well. So let's do this. You can see we need to create an instance of msxml2.domdocument60, and if you want to know all of this, there is another call free threaded DOM document 60. But as VBA doesn't support multi-threading, so we just need this MSXML2 DOM document 60. So if you want to learn more, you can go into this particular URL and then learn more about this DOM document 60. So in this XML doc, you'll see that we have a async method. We have validate one parse. So if you set async equals to false, then it will load that XML synchronously. If you set this false, validate on parse, so if you want to validate that XML when it's parsing, and preserve void space, and some other methods. You can set those properties, and then we have this load method, and if you see the documentation, it says XML source, and then you can just provide the file path, and that's how we can load that XML. So let me just show you. So let me just open immediate window. You can press Ctrl G to open this immediate window. I'm going to close this too, and let's run this. And I'm going to see if it has all of those XML that we see in the file. Now you can see that this is the XML of that particular file, and we have the same structure here as well. You can see book ID, author, first name, last name, and so on. Now there are a couple method that parse error, so you can see that if it is successfully parsed that information or not. So you can just do parse error, and you can see zero, that means it successfully parsed that information. You can see that if it's parsed actually, so that's the boolean, so that is true. And you can also see ready state, so If it's 4, then it will say that completely loaded. You can see that actually in this documentation. So that is ready state. This one indicates the current state, and there is 4 different state actually. One is loading, loaded, interactive, and completed. So the 4th one is completed. So if it's 4, then it's fully ready. Okay, so these are the property of that XML, and this is how we can load the XML from a file. That's it for this video. In the next video, I'm going to show you how can we load XML from a string variable, like just from an active cell string. So that's it for this video. If you like the video, consider subscribing. Have a good day.